If you feel lost learning to code, stay with me for a minute. You're not the problem. Nobody ever gave you a clear map. And today, I'm going to give you a simple 30-day plan that finally changes that. If you keep restarting, hopping between tutorials, switching languages, switching paths, I want you to hear something. You're not behind, you're not slow, you're not broken. You're just overwhelmed. And I know what that feels like because when I first started learning to code, long before I ever became a professional, I spent months pretending I finally got it. I'd watch the tutorial, not along, rewind it 20 times, and the moment I tried to build something on my own, my mind went completely blank. If you're new here, hi, I'm Pete and I've been writing code professionally since 2012. My job with this channel is to help beginners who feel lost, overwhelmed, and stuck in tutorial hell, because that was me for years and I know how it feels. So in this video, I'm giving you the roadmap I wish someone gave me. By the end, you will know exactly what to do next, not a thousand paths, not randomness, not guesswork, just a clear 30-day plan that actually builds confidence. A roadmap you can follow whether you're learning web development, Python, game development, or anything else, because the process is the same. So let's start with the part that changes everything, the IKEA method. Right now, you're learning to code the same way we all built our first IKEA furniture. You open the box, you see 82 screws, 4 wooden planks, and 2 weird metal pieces that look like they belong to a spaceship. And there is no manual. You're not dumb, you're just starting at chaos with no clear first step. But here's the part nobody tells beginners. You're not struggling because coding is hard, you're struggling because you don't know what piece goes first. Once you know that, everything becomes so much easier. So here's the method I want you to use. I call it the IKEA method. And yes, if you've seen my AI video, it follows the same clarify, create, check rhythm I always teach. But here, we're applying it to learn coding without depending on AI. Let me explain it really simply. Step one, clarify. Find page one. When you build IKEA furniture, you don't try to understand the whole manual, right? You look for page one. One tiny clear instruction. Coding works the same way. Every day, pick one tiny concept. Not JavaScript, not Python, not build a game, just one thing. Variables, loops, functions, a button click, a player movement. Most beginners try to learn everything, and they end up learning, guess what? Nothing. But once you find your page one, now you can finally move. Step two, create. Build the first piece yourself. In IKEA, page one is always something tiny, like connecting 2 pieces of wood. It looks silly, but it's actually the foundation of the whole thing. This is where tutorial hell destroys people. You watch the instructor attach the planks, but you never touch them. So of course everything collapses the moment you try alone. Coding is the same. Take your one concept and build a tiny thing with it. A button, a color change, a calculation, a character jump, a file reader, whatever fits your path. It doesn't have to be pretty, it doesn't have to be perfect, it just has to be yours. Step three, check. Close the manual and rebuild it from memory. The final IKEA test is simple. Can you rebuild that tiny piece without looking at the picture? Same with coding. Close the tutorial, close the notes, close the AI. Try to build the same tiny thing again from memory. You will forget things, you will struggle, you will hesitate, and that struggle, that's exactly when real learning happens. This is how you escape tutorial hell. Not by watching more, but by proving to yourself, even for 30 messy seconds a day, that you can stand on your own. So let's summarize what we've got so far. Find page one, build the tiny piece, rebuild it without the manual. That's the IKEA method. And if you do this consistently, coding stops feeling like 82 random screws and starts feeling like something you can actually put together. Now, let me show you exactly what to do in the next 30 days so you never feel lost again. The 30-day roadmap. Week one is simple. Learn the absolute basics of your chosen path. Not everything, just the fundamentals. Whether it's HTML, CSS, Python basics, Unity basics, it doesn't matter. Every day, pick one tiny concept. Clarify. Build something tiny with it. Create. Then try to rebuild it without looking. Check. Week one isn't about fireworks. It's about building the screws that hold everything else together. Week two, build momentum with micro projects. Week two is your turning point. This is where you stop watching and start building. Create 3 to 5 micro projects. Tiny things that take 15 to 30 minutes each. One concept per project. No tutorial copying. For web development, build a color changer or a simple counter. For Python, a calculator or dice roller. For game development, maybe a jump mechanic. These little wins make your brain go, wait, maybe I can actually do this. Week 3, build your first real mini project. Now, my friend, we level up. This is the week where you build something that feels real. Not perfect, not portfolio ready, just something you made from scratch. A mini landing page, a CLI app, a tiny 2D level. Break it into pieces and build each piece using the IKEA method. By the end of week 3, you stop feeling like someone who's trying to learn coding and start becoming someone who codes. Week 4, build your routine and developer identity. Week 4 isn't about learning more. It's about learning deeper. Build a routine, even 20 minutes a day. Repeat an old mini project from scratch using your new skills. Ask questions in Discord, maybe post a bit of your progress. This is the week where coding stops being something you try and becomes something you do. Now, before we continue, I want to mention something that's genuinely going to help a lot of you. This part of the video is sponsored by Scrimba. And you know me, I only work with sponsors I genuinely believe can help beginners. Most of you are learning web development, and Scrimba recently launched a backend path, which basically teaches the behind-the-scenes part of websites, so you can go deeper once you're ready. This new path joins their existing front-end, full-stack, and AI engineering paths, so Scrimba is now a complete resource for anyone looking to break into tech as a web developer. What I love about Scrimba is that it basically forces the IKEA method on you. And what I mean by this, you learn one concept, you interact with it immediately, and you practice by actually doing. And you might be thinking, okay, Pete, but how is this different from every other tutorial website? Well, Scrimba has a really cool technology called Scrim. Look how cool it is. The instructor writes code inside your browser as they teach. And then they literally pause the lesson and hand the keyboard over to you. You can take over their code, edit it, break it, fix it, complete the exercise, all inside the video player in your browser. After you try it yourself, you get your feedback, and then the instructor walks you through the solution step by step. It's insanely interactive, and it makes learning feel fun instead of overwhelming. And here's the best part. You can start completely for free. Test the platform, try the lessons, play around, zero pressure. If you ever want to go deeper, the Pro Plan unlocks everything. All premium courses, unlimited challenges, AI feedback, course completion certificates, and full access to their Discord community, where you can find those who are also on your course and get feedback and help. It's really supportive and super friendly. And if you ever decide to upgrade to Pro, my link below gives you an extra 20% off. If you're learning Python or doing game development or anything else, don't worry, everything in this video still applies 100%. Just follow the roadmap with your own tools and check the resource links below to get your discount. All right, let's get back to building your momentum. Your first tiny win. Okay, you've listened long enough. Now it's time to do something. Don't worry, I'm not sending you to build Netflix or Game Engine. Your first win is intentionally tiny, because tiny wins build big confidence. So here's your assignment. Pick one tiny action related to your path. If you're doing web development, maybe it's adding text or making a button change color. If you're doing Python, maybe it's printing something or doing a small calculation. If you're doing game development, maybe it's moving a character a few pixels. Build it even if it looks terrible. And then the magic part. Close everything and rebuild it from memory. That's your first tiny win for today. And once you do this, even if it takes 30 seconds, something changes. You stop feeling like someone who's watching coding, and you start feeling like someone who codes. Drop a comment saying, I'm going to win today. And when you finish your tiny task, come back and write, I got my win today. That is your first accountability step. And believe me, that's the beginning of your new dev life. If you want, you can share it on our Discord server as well. There are some awesome people in there. Links below. Now, remember that you're not behind, you're not old, you're not bad at coding. You're just missing a clear path, and now you have one. If this video helped you, give it a like and subscribe, because I'm dropping more videos to help you escape tutorial hell, build real projects, and finally become the developer you know you can be. Thanks for watching, you legends. I'm Pete, and I'll see you on the next one.